Hello everyone, my name is Rosalyn Streeter. I am a seer and prophet of God to the nations. And on this journey, you will soon learn it's just so much easier with God. So welcome to the journey of vision and let's chat. All right, you guys, so I'm back again. Here go another direct message. So from God, and this video is actually called God Said, Tell Them, My People, to focus on the promised land, not the things of this world. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and read into what he has said. So he said, tell them also to focus more on the promised land and not the things of this world. When I said I was going to prepare a place for you, but I'm leaving you with a friend, I meant me. The Holy Spirit is me. And I am my spirit. This is how I know. I told you I would never leave you or forsake you. This promise I kept. To never leave you was to leave you with a substitution of me. That is me, my spirit. I am he, Jesus. Do you understand? I never left you, children of God. You left me. You feel all alone, but I'm still right here. Your focus is all wrong. So when God said, I never left you, children of God, you left me. I could see it was like God was here. And then you guys, there are some of you guys who are just far away from him. And God was saying, you left me. You understand? So he's like, I'm still here, but you left me. So there was a time when you was with God, right? Let's say you was walking with him, you talked to him every day, you heard him clearly. You started to understand him better here, okay? But as you started to inch away because of the things of this world, when God would speak, it became difficult for you to hear because you was far away, right? So, for example, if you are standing right beside me and I'm speaking to you, you're going to hear me. But if you move a mile away from me and I'm still in the same position and I speak to you in the same tone, in the same way, would you hear me the same way? So that's what God is saying. Do you understand? I never left you, children of God. You left me. You feel all alone, but I'm still right here. Your focus is all wrong. You focus more on worldly things, the things of this world. This has been your focus. So move these thoughts from your mind and focus on me, your promise. Yes, I have prepared a place for you. And I can't wait for you to see it. You will be shocked at all the details I have for you. Study about the one who promised you these things, me, the I Am. This is who you should study. Rosalyn, many of my children want more from me. But still, do they know me as they should? No, Rosalind, they don't. Tell them that I dwell in them. Me, my spirit. The Holy Spirit is alive in them. Learn about my spirit so you know when I lead, when I want to comfort you. So you know I am standing with you. Learn about me, or do you know me? So he said, learn about me, or do you know me? I want more from you. And it's interesting he said, I want more from you, because have you ever noticed a lot of people, children of God, it's all about what God can do for them, right? A lot of times it's not about what we can do for him. And that's what God is saying, I want more from you. I want you to learn about the Father that you call on, that you need right by your side, your helper, your comforter. Learn about me, learn about my spirit and the reason why I left, my God, the reason why I actually left my spirit for you here, right? There is a season coming where you will have to be in tune with my instructions and my directions that I will send directly to you, not through my messengers, but to you. You have to be closer to me. Get closer to me so you can hear me clearly. My sheep know my voice. You say you are my sheep, but you can't hear me. Why is that? Let me answer, my son, my daughter. It's our relationship. How often do you come to me before you try to fix it yourself? When do you take time to sit still and listen to my voice? I can't remember when. And so I sense that, you know, God is saying there are some of his children who they really want to hear from God. But God said there is a part that you have to play in this, that you actually have to do. And he's also holding us all accountable. And I love that, because even me as a messenger, yes, I'm here to give you your, you know, direct messages from God. But at the end of the day, what if there's no YouTube, right? What if you're in a place by yourself, alone? You don't have a phone, you don't have a computer, you know, you can't connect to anyone else, right? What if you need prayer? What if you need something from God and you look to the woman or man, the messenger that was sent, that you know about, to give you this word, right? But how would you get it if you don't have the phone, if you don't have any connection or contact with that person? Are you going to wait a week, right, until you get out of this situation for you to reach out to that person? No, that's not what God wants, because what are you doing? You're dependent on that person. And my God, God said, depend on me. Get closer to me to a point where you can hear me. He said, my sheep know my voice. And if you call yourself my child, then are you not his sheep? And if you are his sheep, my God, if you're his sheep, should you not know his voice? So God says, spend time with him, learning his voice. So that way when someone else speaks to you, you know, my God doesn't speak that way. Get behind me, Satan. Because I know when God calls my name, my Father. Okay, so that was for someone. And he said, it's our relationship is the issue. That's what he was saying, the relationship. And we can kind of take this right to a situation where you're trying to, like, say, you know, you're looking for a woman or a man, you know, you're trying to build this, or a friendship, and you're trying to build this relationship. Could you build a relationship with someone and with distance? You don't talk to them, you don't call them, you don't FaceTime them, you don't do anything, right? Every blue moon you reach out to them, potentially because you want something. How is that a relationship? Would you not call on them a month later and they say, oh, I'm sorry, who is this? Right? Do I know you? There's no relationship. Okay? So God's like, I want to build a relationship with you, my child. You know, as your father, I need to understand you. Right? And I think that is, again, romantic that our father wants a relationship with us. And it's not a simple relationship, you know, like high and by, an intimate relationship. He wants to know the things that you like, you know? Like me, I really enjoy perfume. And God knows that. And he gifted me with that, right? There's certain things that I like, and God will, I told you, he's just romantic. but he'll do certain things where I'm like, you just melt my heart for real. Like you, I was like, Lord, stop it. Seriously, just stop. But don't stop, okay? So anyway, let me keep going here. He said, how often do you come to me before you try to fix it yourself? How many of you guys find yourself praying and you know after your prayer, you're still going to go try to figure it out yourself? You're not going to wait on God to do it for you. You already have it in your mind what you're going to do, right? And it's like, God's like, hey, do you want me to help you or do you want to help yourself at this point? When do you take the time to sit still and listen to my voice? I can't remember when. God, my God said, I can't even remember when you took time to sit with me and talk with me. Jesus. But I want you to know I'm still right here. He's so good. So let's rebuild. He's like, let's start over, you guys. Let's rebuild our relationship. So this is exciting, right? That God wants to rebuild with you and us. And he said, let's rebuild our relationship the right way. He said, I'm pretty cool, as he said before. He said, I'm pretty cool, I promise. You will love me as I do you. Study me, learn me, my voice. Know who your father is before that great day. And he's talking about his coming. This part, he's not talking about the wealth transfer. He's talking about his coming. So you will know the sound of my coming. My God, as I said before, God gives me so much, I forget what I wrote down. But it's beautiful when it lines up. So you will know when I instruct you. You will know that I love you. So you know I never left you alone. And then he said, I love you, my child. I'm done, Rosalind. Thank you. I love that. I love that. And also, there was a part in here when God said, "In this, there's a season coming where you will have to be in tune with my instructions and my directions." And so here's the thing. Definitely with God's coming, right, you need to be prepared for his coming. There's a lot of things that we have to get in line with our lives, and God has already started talking to me about it. And so which, you know, there will be messages that I will be getting out soon related to that. But also, if you think about what's happening in this world today, it's not just like one little fire, right? It is so much going on, different things going on, that you can get so distracted, right? And you can get to a place where you're hearing all these different voices from people, right? That what happens, it disconnects you from God and what is true. Because see, here's the thing, God has already drew a line, and he has his children of God, and he has the ones that he does not know, the ones who have decided they don't want to live for God. No matter what you do for them, you guys, you know, they won't turn. That's what God said. Even if he gave them the option to turn, and he said, but they won't. So now this is judgment. So he already drew the line here, okay? And so here's the thing, a lot of stuff, we still live in the same world. So all this stuff can be happening in different moments of, you know, in different moments, and a lot that's going on. You know, you maybe watch the news and you see all this is happening, but you need to recognize what is your portion, right? I mean, you're more than welcome to pray and all of that. That's fine. But God also wants you to understand, even in this season, my God, you need to be celebrating what He has for His people and His kingdom, because what is happening is not your portion. And if you're not close to God, you won't know that. You'll be listening to people who are not of God and what's going on in their lives, and you think that's coming to you, and it's not, because you're covered, Jesus. I encourage you, if you haven't already watched it, watch the video related to the deaf angel that God allowed me to see, okay? And you know, just watch that video, and it helps you understand what is for us and what is not for us. God is not playing in this hour. My God, the God of love is here for His people. He is here to take care of the things and move certain things out of our lives, and I'm okay with that. Trust me, I'm okay with that. Okay? And so anyway, so just hold on, you guys. Again, focus on God. Focus on what He has for you, the things He has for you, and not the things of this world. It's not your portion. And if you don't know what's your portion, God has released so many direct messages on this channel. I can't vouch for other channels, because I promise you, I just don't be on YouTube like that just to be watching videos, because I have so much work to do on my own with what God gives me. But I'm pretty sure there's other messengers that God has already, you know, released to as well, where you can find confirmation and understand your portion. So that is it for this video. I have a lot more, you guys. At this point, probably a good maybe nine after this. So I mean, depending on what God gives me over the weekend. So I am definitely working hard for the children of God, because you guys matter to me. You really do, and you matter to our Father. So remember, take all of this to God. Take it all to Him, but He do want to build that relationship with you, because at the end of the day, it's going to matter. It's going to matter that you'll be able to hear Him and understand when He asks you to move a certain way. You know that it's your Father telling you, and it's not someone else. So to God be the glory for just allowing us to even know certain things about this world, to know certain things about our Father. Take time to study about Him, learn about Him, learn about the way He moved, even when it came to other people, when it came to situations and circumstances He had to go through when He walked on this earth. So you know, I'm so in love with love. God is definitely love, and we love you. Bye.